Residents and small businesses in parts of Metro Manila scramble to save enough supply of water as Water Concessionaire Maynilad starts implementing its daily water interruptions. Vivian Gulia reports.
Water containers lined up outside a water refilling station in Navota City hours before Maynilad begins implementing daily water service interruptions Wednesday night. Among those who went for a refill is Concepcion.
Mahirap na pag naubusan ng tubig, kaya nag-ipon.
The Navota City Hospital has issued a memo advising staff to conserve water amid the onset of El Nino. But the hospital management issues assurance its water tanks are sufficient to support uninterrupted services for the duration of the nightly water interruption.
Yung 3 tanks po natin na naka-prepare, eh, nagla-last po ito ng 4 days if in case totally maka-cut off po yung supply ng water. Continue lang po ang services namin.
Pinag-aaralan namin na paano makapagbawas sa tubig na hindi naapektuhan yung trabaho namin. Magamit po kami minsan ng mga equipment ng mga chemical na lang po namin katulad ng air freshener.
The Navota City government says water tankers from the Bureau of Fire and volunteer organizations are on standby to ration water if needed.
Mga residents naman, any concern po nila, 24 hours nandyan po yung ating text JRT, nandyan yung social media na may nagbabantay at yung mga hotlines po natin. So pwede silang tumawag para makadala tayo ng tulong.
In Caloocan City, some residents have adjusted the schedule for activities that use plenty of water, like cleaning the house, doing the laundry, and bathing.
Maglilinis ako minsan gabi. Kasi mainit, di ba? Mga 7, ganun.
Pero ngayon?
Eh, maaga ako dahil sabi mga 7 mawawalan, di ba?
Siguro kailangan lahat makaligo na before 5 o'clock. So yung mga naka-store, hindi na siya magagalaw unless magsi-CR lang talaga. Oh, lahat ng kasama namin sa bahay, alam na yon.
In Malabon City, a store selling water to fish vendors in the market expressed concern the daily water service interruptions will affect his sales since the business is busiest between 8 p.m. and 4 a.m.
Aking bagay po, pandagdag po sa ano po yun, sa kita ng tubig. Wala po kasing po pwesto yun pagka maraming drum. Kasi mamaya po, puno po yung tindahan yung sidahan mamaya. Magdadagdag po po mamaya po, dalawang drum.
Nearly 600,000 Maynilad customers in 6 Metro Manila cities are expected to experience 9 to 11 hour daily water service interruptions. It is scheduled to start every 7 p.m. in parts of Quezon City, Caloocan, Malabon, Valenzuela, Navotas, and Manila. This comes as Angat Dam Reservoir's water level continues to fall below the minimum operating level of 180 meters for the 5th straight day. On Wednesday morning, it was at 178.21 meters.
Itong binigay sa atin na alokasyon na 48 cubic meters per second, konti na ang nakakarating na supply dito sa ating treatment plant sa Quezon City. So ibig sabihin dahil konti na yung supply, kapos na siya sa pangangailangan ng Maynilad para mapanatili po yung normal na servisyo ng tubig sa ating concession area.
Maynilad says it targets to reduce the hours of water service interruptions.
Dahil meron tayong additional supply naman na nakukuha sa ating supply augmentation projects, mag-improve dapat ito as long as the allocation remains the same. Pwedeng, for example, in some areas, 8 p.m. mag-umpisa or 9 p.m. Again, depending on the availability of water in our treatment plants.
Maynilad has yet to give a timeline on until when the water service interruptions will last, but Rufo says it could stay as long as allocation for water concessionaires from Angat Dam is at 48 cubic meters per second. Vivian Gulia, ABS-CBN News.
Let's get an update on the weather now from PAGASA forecaster Rhea Torres. Seems like it's a gloomy Thursday morning. Rhea, what do you have for us?
Thank you, Nikki. As of the moment, we are monitoring a low pressure area estimated at 295 kilometers east of Infanta, Quezon. Meanwhile, the southwest monsoon continues to affect southern Luzon, Visayas, and Mindanao. Therefore, large portions of the country besides Davao region and Sogsarjan will be experiencing cloudy skies with scattered rain showers and thunderstorms due to the effects of the southwest monsoon as well as the low pressure area. Meanwhile, isolated rain showers or thunderstorms may be expected over Davao region and Sogsarjan, usually by the afternoon or the evening. And we are expecting these weather systems to persist until this coming weekend, so rainy skies will still be expected until this coming weekend over large portions of Luzon and Visayas. Meanwhile, for the state of our coastal waters, light to moderate sea conditions are still expected, and we currently have no gale warning raised over the seaboards of our country. Therefore, for our fisher folks and those with small sea crafts, they are still free to venture out into the sea, although warnings for those who are planning to venture out since we are expecting offshore thunderstorms over some parts of the Luzon and Visayas area. And that is the latest here from Pag-asa Weather Forecasting Center. This is Rhea Torres reporting.
All right, thanks for that update, Rhea. You stay safe in July. The controversial Maharlika Investment Fund bill set to be signed by President Marcos on July 18th. That's according to Senate President Juan Miguel Zubiri. He earlier said Marcos would sign the bill before his second State of the Nation address on July 24th. The creation of the Maharlika Fund has been overshadowed by concerns over the sources of its seed capital and possible corruption. A mall in Quezon City has sacked the security guard who was captured on a video throwing a helpless puppy from an overpass. The security guard was reportedly trying to drive away vendors from the overpass, including the child who owned the puppy. The puppy did not survive the 5-meter drop. An animal welfare group, meanwhile, is set to file a complaint against the guard for violating the Animal Welfare Act.
Imprisonment po ito ng up to 2 years and or fine not exceeding 100,000 pesos.
It's a position of power. Meron niyang baril, meron niya ano. So baka he needs to have a psychological evaluation para to hold that job. Dahil hindi talaga siya nagpakita ng tolerance eh.
The country's first transgender woman lawmaker calling out fellow members of the LGBTQIA+ community after a drag performance of the Lord's Prayer drew flack online. In a message to ABS-CBN News, Bataan Representative Geraldine Roman said, as a Catholic, she was offended by the performance. She also reminded those who cite the constitutional right to free expression that the said freedom was not absolute. The drag queen, Pura Duca Vega, meanwhile insists the performance meant no disrespect and the use of the song and symbolism was intentional. China also refusing to accept or recognize the 2016 arbitral win of the Philippines. That landmark victory invalidated China's expansive claims in the South China Sea, with the International Tribunal at The Hague upholding Manila's sovereign rights over the West Philippine Sea. Beijing now claims the ruling has been widely questioned by the international community, but Wednesday's show of support from diplomats on the 7th anniversary of the ruling says otherwise.
The United States believes that all countries, large and small, should play by the same rules. With the arbitral ruling, international law won out, protecting a nation's sovereign and economic rights.
We have to show that we have capabilities to protect our sovereignty and our national interests. And if like-minded countries come together to do that, of course the effect of it will be greater.
To further inform the public about Manila's arbitral victory over Beijing, the Foreign Affairs Department launched a microsite about the ruling. Now this site's title, Not One Inch, was attributed to President Marcos's previous statement that the country won't lose an inch of its territory. The DFA says the microsite will provide a central resource for official information and positions on the award and its contributions to the rule of law and peaceful settlement of disputes through UNCLOS. A former Philippine Solicitor General, meanwhile, suggests another case may be filed against Beijing over its maritime dispute with Manila. Francis Hamdeleza notes the Philippines had only filed for a declaration of rights and not of damages in its 2013 complaint. Now, Hamdeleza says the Office of the Solicitor General can choose from a menu of cases it can still file against China. But he points out that immediate action ultimately lies with President Marcos.
Of course, we all have to remember that ultimately the decision of how best to proceed or not to proceed will reside solely with our beloved president as the chief architect of our foreign policy. It is my hope, however, that on the 7th anniversary of our historic win, we pause and consider the lessons of our victory and be guided as we engage in spirited debate on how best to achieve the same patriotic goal.
Philippine senators slammed the seeming lack of control of Filipino shareholders and the National Grid Corporation of the Philippines. See, 60% of the NGCP is owned by Filipino businessmen, while the remaining 40% belongs to Chinese stakeholders. But the NGCP revealed its board cannot even convene and come up with a collective decision without a representative from China.
Majority kami, 60%, but I cannot make any decisions. For me, that's a de facto veto by the minority.
That's not
what is being contemplated by the Constitution. The Constitution gave us 60% so we can make decisions. My point is we're violating the Constitution because we cannot make a decision.
Filipinos can always be in control, management-wise, finance-wise, and the operations. But how can you be in control if you cannot call for a board meeting?
The scolding comes after the Energy Regulatory Commission earlier flagged NGCP for delays in the completion of power projects. Another senator, meanwhile, calls for higher taxes on the grid operator.
Pag-aralan natin, no, yung 3% franchise tax ng NGCP, pwede siguro natin taasan yun. Number 3, yung corporate income tax na rin. Baka pwede nating malaking makukuha natin dyan, Pondo. Ang laki ng makukuha natin kung taasan natin yung franchise tax at yung corporate income tax ng NGCP.